Well, it is Musical Tuesday here on Carolina Morning.
Yeah, Todd Taylor, the fastest banjo player in the world, according to Guinness Book of World Records, is here. Of course, he's also a local and famous and sought after by all kinds of bands around the country. Mm-hmm. Thanks for being here, Todd.
Well, you know, I'm in Spartanburg for a couple of days, and this is my home, Channel 7 is. Mm-hmm. Matter of fact, just seen Jack Roper come by. I was on his show when I was a kid, Kid Sizzle. And Channel 7 is dear to my heart.
Yeah.
It used to be on the Farmer Gray show, but I love my state of South Carolina, and I love the people of South Carolina, and I have not been on TV around here in a while to say, let everybody know, you know, my health-wise, I still suffer from mitochondriomyopathy, the rare muscle disease, and I'm in remission. I have good days and bad days, but I'm still doing good. But hey, a lot of good things going on the road as much as I can be, doing, give a shout out to the Oak Ridge Boys. You know, that's the greatest country group of all time.
And my brother. And Elvira's one of their good songs.
Yeah, matter of fact, we just had a show in Spartanburg. They did, and we were over at the District 3 community. Hey, if you hadn't got tickets, Roy Graves has got them at itickets.com. Oak Ridge Boys, the 22nd, the 28th of March 2020. Okay. Now, the tickets are on sale now, so if you want your tickets, you need to get them now.
Wow. And you're talking about next year?
That's right, because the last time the show sold out in like 2 days.
So you've played with them, right?
Oh, yeah. They're good friends of mine, known them for a long time. They're like my brothers. They're great. I've worked with a lot of people in the music industry, some of the biggest stars you can dream of, but my favorite, and they're like family to me, are the Oak Ridge Boys, even the band. The band's great and all.
I watched this video, Todd, and the first question that comes to my mind is, how do you do that? How did you get started in banjo?
I'd like to give the Lord the glory, number one, for what he's done for my life and everything, with my disease and everything, and he gave me the talent. But even though I got the talent from the Lord, it takes lots of practice. Mm-hmm. I've been playing since I was 6 years old.
Six.
And music's healing. And the banjo's helped me through a lot of hard times and everything with life and everything like that. And if anybody's out there today watching that's got any kind of problem, medical issues or anything, you know, just stay positive like I did and stay positive every day and do the best you can, and the good Lord will bring you through it.
Awesome. You know, you seem to have such an appreciation of life. Well, when you have something like that and you say it got you through, how long have you been dealing with this issue?
Well, I was diagnosed in my late 20s, and I was in a wheelchair. I like to die twice, but give a shout out to Spartanburg Regional Medical Center, the best medical team in the world. They've been there for me for the past couple of months when I've been sick. And then my doctor, Dr. Weaver, if he's watching, hey, love you, Dr. Weaver. But, you know, and just in general, just keeping a positive attitude. And I go to Emory University. That's where the main doctor is for the disease. But there's two of my new books right there. That's on Hal Leonard, the biggest music print publisher in the world, CenterStream Hal Leonard, and Joe Bonzel of the Oak Ridge Boys. Yeah. He wrote the foreword for the one on the left, the 50 banjo licks. And I understand you want to learn to play the banjo.
Well, it's on one of my pie in the sky, you know, bucket list type things. But do you get nervous getting up there on stage and just, because you got to know so many
Something, being in this industry for my whole life, it's really all I know.
Yeah.
It's kind of like you doing the newscast. It's it's like you in a different dimension when you hit the stage. I mean, because it's a different situation everywhere you go, and it's hard to explain. It's like when I'm playing, it's like God's playing my banjo.
Yeah.
It must be something to have a talent like that.
Yeah,
you know?
And I love meeting the fans, and I want everybody in Spartanburg to know I love Spartanburg, and Governor McMaster, I love him. You know,
a day named after you.
Yeah, the holiday South Carolina Banjo Day in honor of Todd Taylor for contributions to South Carolina, and that was an honor. Even after getting the Order of the Palmetto, but playing in the governor's office, I was the first person in history to ever play in the governor's office twice.
That's awesome.
Governor plays the guitar too.
Oh, okay.
White House appearance coming up within the next month or month and a half too.
Ohio.
Well, you got a lot going on.
Sure do.
For a man with a medical condition, and you've overcome that, and God's been good.
You know, music heals.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I wrote a song called Waterfall, and I like to go to hospitals and play for cancer patients, and it's amazing how they smile when they hear that music.
It does. Music is healing. Well, Todd, we do have to go. We got to run, but thank you so much for coming
it's
in.
It's been great being with you, ladies.
Great to meet you. And one day, Todd, one day.
South Carolina, Spartanburg, I love you guys.
All right.
We'll be right back with more Carolina Morning.